Hi everyone, my name is Aditya and I'm a developer evangelist at Salesforce. In this quick take, I'm going to show you how you can import and use LWC OSS components that have been built and packaged by other developers in your own projects. In case you're wondering how you can package your own components, then check out my other quick take linked in the description below. Let's get started. Before we go ahead and import components, we must first understand the concept of module resolution. Like the name suggests, module resolution is a process that helps resolve any imports within the code base, which basically means telling the LWC compiler where the components that you have imported are present. In a typical project, you'll see two different kinds of imports. First, in the HTML file where you embed a component, you can think of this to be an import. The second is in the JavaScript file where you can import components or libraries using the import syntax. At build time, the LWC compiler has to figure out based on these imports where this library or this web component are physically present in the project. This process is called module resolution. The LWC config.json lists all the modules that LWC compiler is going to resolve during build time. The modules key in this file is going to hold an array of what we call module records. So a module record is an object with a specific shape depending on the type of module record it holds. There are three types of module records. First, a directory module record, which basically says, here is a directory which contains all the components. And this is the module record type that we have just seen in LWC config.json, which is added by default and says all the components are present in the src/modules folder. The next type of module record is an npm module record that says this is the name of the npm package in which you'll find some LWC components. And this is the type that we'll be using today when we import components from the npm registry. And finally, you have the alias module record. This is useful if you want to specify the source of just one or two components that are present in different folders. So what you do here is you specify the name of the component and where its implementation is present. You can also use this module record type when you're trying to reuse an LWC from Salesforce, which gets data from, let's say, an Apex method. So LWC OSS won't be able to resolve this imported Apex method because the Apex method doesn't exist outside Salesforce. So what we can do here is we can use the alias module record to specify an alternate implementation. Here it's a JavaScript file. Now that you've understood the concept of module resolution, let's see how you can import a component from the NPM registry. In this quick take, I'll be importing the LWC clock utils package, which contains the clock timer component. To import this package, you need to run the command npm install package name. So let's copy the package name. And back in our project, let's run the command npm install the package name. Once the import is complete, you need to let the LWC compiler know that there are some Lightning web components present in this package. For that, you'll have to add a module record as we discussed before. So let's add a new module record. In this case, it's going to be an npm module record. So give it the name npm and the name of the package. In this case, LWC clock utils. Now you can use any component or library from the package in your custom components. Let's do that. I'm going to add the timer component inside app.html. So let me open it and I'll put the timer right underneath the image. So I say clock-timer. And looking at the documentation for the timer, we can see that it takes in two attributes. One is duration in seconds, which is a required attribute. So let me give it to be 30. And there is an optional attribute start on load that tells if the timer has to start when it loads. So let's just do that. and save. Let me run the watch command to see it in action. Now let me go to the browser and open localhost 3001. Here you go. You can see the timer in action. To quickly recap what we have done, we have just installed the package from npm registry using the command npm install. And then we have created an npm module record in the LWC config.json file. And these are the only two steps you need to import and use third-party Lightning web components in your own projects. Before you leave, I want to call your attention to the Lightning base components package that lets you use base components with LWC OSS. And all you need to do to use them is follow the steps that we have just seen. Thank you for watching. If you have learned something, be sure to like this video. If you want to get more content like this pushed directly to you, click subscribe and click that bell icon to get notifications.